Sophie, welcome.
Thank you. Hi.
Really happy that you're here because it would have been, it's your only free day, right?
Yes,
For the past couple of months.
I know. Well, yeah, kind of. Yeah. I know. No, this was sort of supposed to be our free day since we've been touring now for 6 weeks. So you can imagine not everyone in the crew was happy when I announced that we were going to come here. But then I explained to them what a great show it is and that it's, it's the first time we get to do radio in Holland. So if we don't do it, we're stupid. And then I also promised them that we're going to have a hotel in Brighton for 2 nights. And so then like this, I kind of made peace.
Yeah, you bribed them a little bit. If you know, but we get really good food, free food.
That too, yes. Lots. We got 28 bottles of natural wine in Brussels this morning because we're continental Europeans. We're so scared of going to England because we think there is no food there and they don't drink any decent. Yeah, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. Yeah, just lager and fish and chips and that's it.
Which is okay.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with you if you like it. It's just that, you know, we prefer natural wine.
Yeah. 3 times a day, yes.
Yes, okay. You write songs in all kinds of different languages. You have lived in Bern, Berlin.
Yes. And in London as well.
London.
And what did you say? And in Bonn, which is also in Germany.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And in Switzerland, so you master English and German very well. You also studied it, right?
I think so, yes.
And your French is on point as well.
Yeah, my French, when I started to do music, that was really weird. My first record deal I had in France, and at that time I didn't speak French. And then I was suddenly surrounded by all these French-speaking people, and people who know France know that French people don't only, I mean, they only speak French, as the English only speak English. It's funny how these great big countries are quite limited, aren't they? And us coming from the small countries, we always have to learn all these languages. So within a couple of months, I hurt myself saying French things.
Is it an advantage when you're writing music?
To know different languages.
So many different languages. I can also imagine that, for example, when you're in France for a long time, you're more French orientated, but it's not your first language. So
yes, yeah, maybe then it makes you feel more free when you sing it because you're not quite aware of all the interpretations that the sentence offers. So you may be just freer in your expression, I guess. Yeah. More ignorant, and ignorance leads to freedom in a certain way.
To bliss, yeah. Is there a language? Where you prefer writing in?
I like Swiss German, which is my mother tongue. Only a few people speak this language. It's more like a secret code that we have. That's the language I like. I like most.
But you write in Swiss German and then translate to English, or
no. But when I write in Swiss German, I keep it in Swiss German. Yeah.
Which language is best for love songs? You think for you?
I don't know. That's very hard. I don't know. I'm sorry, I don't have an answer.
Angry songs?
Angry songs?
Mm-hmm.
English, probably, in a way, yeah.
I would have figured German, you know, us Dutch people really like to swear in German, for
really?
Example.
Really? So what are the words you know in German for swearing?
Arschloch.
Arschloch, okay.
Dumpfbacke.
Okay.
Or just, you know, when you...
What's Arschloch in... Oh, no, I know something. Geen Halsklotzak.
Een genereuze klootzak.
Genegauwste klootzak.
Ik weet niet wat een genegauwste klootzak is.
What does that mean?
Ja, een klootzak is just, a motherfucker.
Oh, okay.
Something like, well, not literally. Yeah, well, like a dumbass.
What does clothes mean, the first word?
Balls.
Balls. And suck?
Suck?
Suck.
Balzak.
Like balls.
Yeah, balls, yeah.
Okay.
This is a very intellectual show. This. I will ask you one more kind of smart question, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. And it's about your love for Amy Winehouse.
Yeah.
And your reference in the song Tricks that you just played. It's about the attempt of fighting for the attention of someone who's obsessed with his pain. Can you explain this reference?
Yeah, well, there is a line in this song that I'm just going to play now. It's called There Is Still Pain Left. And there's just the word black. And ever since I heard Amy Winehouse, I cannot sing the word black without trying to imitate the way. It's as if this word belongs to her and there's only one way you can sing the word black, which is the Amy way. And
can you do it here?
Black. Kind of like that, but lower.
Wow. But for example, when somebody says the word as well, do you hear?
I find it already annoying. Like the word should be removed from normal conversation. Yeah.
So people aren't allowed to use that word. Do you have this with other words or only with the word black?
With the word enfant. It always reminds me of the French national anthem, Allons enfants de la paix. Then I always think of war and stuff like that, even though that it's supposed to mean children. Yeah.
Yeah, I really understand. Yeah, of course.